Well, my name is Tom Murray, and I'm running for the North Carolina House. I've been in the House, this is my second term, so I can still remember what motivated me to run in 2010. When my wife and I were making this decision, the unemployment rate in North Carolina was over 11%. Teachers were getting furloughed, class size was increased, and teacher pay was frozen. And I knew that North Carolina could do better, and I wanted to be part of a solution. And so since then, we went to work on improving North Carolina's economy. The unemployment rate has dropped 5 points in 4 years. The private sector has created almost 250,000 jobs, and now tax base is increasing so we can invest in our education system. And we were able to give teachers a raise this year and spend over $282 million on teacher pay this year. That's why I'm running, to keep North Carolina's economy moving forward so we can invest in our public priorities. The tax plan that we implemented this year was historic. The burden on business and families in our state was ranked 44th in the country. And the tax reform plan that we implemented this year moved us up to 17th best in the country. I like the plan that we implemented. I think we need to let it work. I think it's going to take about 3 years for us to fully understand just exactly the impact of the tax reform plan that we implemented. And I would like to see the existing tax plan work before we do any more dramatic changes to the tax system. I'd kind of like to see the economy grow and see what happens in the existing tax plan. I'm not sure if we're going to wait 3 years, but I'd like to at least let it sit for at least the first year of this next biennium, and potentially this next biennium entirely, before we make any more what I would consider heavy lift changes for the tax system. Personally, I'd like to see have all businesses be competitive from a tax system. And so with regards to the film tax credit, the refundability of the tax credit was something that I could just not support. It was something that I just can't understand why we would want to let a company get more back from the state of North Carolina than they invested in our state. So I don't like the existing plan. I wouldn't be necessarily opposed to a grant program, but it definitely would need to be performance-based, and it would need to allow for smaller. For example, I've got a production company in my district that produces a children's television show called The Rusty Bucket Kids, and I haven't seen a single thing that would help that small business in the film incentives conversation. And so if we're not going to be willing to allow anybody to compete for this grant money, then that would be something that would cause me problems. I'd like to see small productions and large productions be able to compete for any grant program that we would have. I'm not convinced that we have a resource in North Carolina for onshore domestic energy exploration for natural gas through hydraulic fracturing. I think people are overselling it on both sides. I'm not convinced that the jobs are going to be there if we do it, and I'm also just based on the statements that I've heard from the Obama administration's, the EPA, both the past two EPA directors for the Obama administration haven't declared significant problems from groundwater contamination. So I think both sides are kind of overselling the issues with regards to hydraulic fracturing. But North Carolina doesn't have the resource that Pennsylvania, North Dakota, Texas has. Now, with respect to offshore drilling, that's an entirely different conversation, because that's the federal government making the decision about how to use federal waters, and North Carolina won't be able to make any unilateral decisions without having a partnership with Virginia and South Carolina. And so the Obama administration's Secretary of Interior has recently allowed for seismic testing, which I think is a good first step, and it makes sure that it can be done safely. But at the end of the day, it's going to be a partnership between the three coastal states, Virginia, North Carolina, South Carolina, and the federal government if we explore offshore drilling. Current General Assembly is a pro-business General Assembly. We like to get down to work and listen to folks, listen to both sides. I think you've got a big tent in the North Carolina General Assembly, and most of the votes that we take are unanimous or super majorities. We do have contentious issues, but I think I've been able to bridge the gap between Republicans and Democrats and kind of be my own person, represent my constituents the best I can. And I've enjoyed working with members of both parties to move North Carolina forward. But if I was going to sum up the North Carolina General Assembly in just a few words, I would say that we are open for business in the state of North Carolina. Well, 2015 is, I think, full of promise. It'll be the last 2 years of a presidential administration, and so I think we've got a tremendous opportunity to continue to move the state of North Carolina forward. I'm chair of the Commerce Committee, and so I'm focused on job creation and economic development. There's one bill that I worked on significantly over the past biennium that didn't quite get across the finish line, and that has to do with crowdfunding, how to help spur small dollar investments in small business and startups, and that's another piece of legislation that I will definitely seek to reintroduce and get passed so we can help our small businesses and startups continue to expand and grow, because that's where real innovation happens in the state of North Carolina. The other big priority for me is connecting our university system with the private sector and make sure that the research that's being done in our university system is producing an economic benefit for the state of North Carolina. I think crowdfunding plays into that, so that's why those two priorities are top of my mind, to make sure that we are innovating in our universities, creating jobs, and moving our state forward. I think what we've done in this General Assembly with regards to the mobility formula and changing how dollars are allocated is a good first step. We, on average, with the old equity formula, we would fund about 170 projects in a year. Through the mobility formula changes, we were able to fund about 360 projects this year. So I think that's a good step in the right direction. I think you're going to have a tough time selling me that we don't collect enough gas tax from our citizens when it comes to road construction. But I think what you saw from the General Assembly is that we collect enough money, we just need to distribute it better. I think for new projects, I think there's a lot of conversation about tolls and a lot of conversations about vehicle miles traveled. I'm not running out and putting a t-shirt on for either one of those concepts, but at the end of the day, I think we need to use the existing dollars wisely and potentially invest in statewide bonds using the existing tax revenue that we get from the gas tax, which I would like to remain capped. And that's one of the things we were able to accomplish in this General Assembly, is to cap and keep that gas tax stable. I would not vote to abolish the death penalty in North Carolina. It's a very serious conversation, and I think it needs to be executed in a fair way, and we also need to pay attention to the victims' families as well. And so I think there's room for a balanced conversation about the death penalty, but I would not vote to abolish the death penalty. We do not need a more full-time legislature. A part-time legislature is what was intended, in my opinion, from the founding fathers of our country. And the more we're there, the more government you get. And I would much rather have folks come in, lend their expertise to the state of North Carolina. I'm the only pharmacist in the General Assembly, so I'm plenty willing to lend my expertise to the state of North Carolina to help move our state forward. But it's better off. We're better off with the part-time legislature. I think voters need to know that my motivation for serving is my three children. I've got a 10-year-old, an 8-year-old, and an 8-month-old. So I want to make sure that my kids, that everybody's kids, has as bright a future as I did when I was their age. And so that's the number one reason I'm running. And my wife and I, we've made plenty of personal sacrifices to be able to enable me to serve in the North Carolina General Assembly, but I'm willing to make those sacrifices because of my kids. And last thing I'd ask folks to remember is that I enjoy knocking on doors and meeting folks. We've knocked on probably close to 4,000 doors in this campaign already. I've lost 20 pounds since the 4th of July. So we're working hard, and if I haven't been to your neighborhood and you'd like me to come, just feel free to contact me through my campaign website, and I'd be glad to visit your neighborhood and talk to your neighbors about how we can move our state forward. Typical Saturday morning, that's a great day in my house because that's a day we know we're going to all sit down and eat breakfast together as a family, whether I'm campaigning or not. We always get up, we kind of stay in our pajamas a little bit longer and get up and eat breakfast together as a family. And then usually when I'm not in the campaign season, we'll go out and participate in some outdoor activities. We love the tobacco trail. It's real close to, it runs right through the middle of my legislative district. And so we jump on our bikes. Unfortunately, the 8-month-old's not old enough to ride a bike or be carried in a bike yet. But as soon as he turns one, we're going to put him in the carrier, strap it to the back of the bike, and the four of us will be riding our bikes on the tobacco trail happily right through District 41. I think from a political perspective, one of the folks I look up to the most is Teddy Roosevelt. He had a lot of political courage during his time, and he also I have a kindred spirit with him because he loved the outdoors, and he preserved plenty of land during his time in the presidency, and that's something that I respect a lot, and they're not making any more of that land, so we want to preserve it for future generations. And so if there's anybody I look up to from a political perspective, probably Teddy Roosevelt. I'm a Republican because I believe that the hardworking families in North Carolina deserve to keep more of their money instead of spending it on a government program that might not work so well. I believe that the government should do very few things and do them exceedingly well. And so that's why I'm a Republican.